In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who caused the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Christ did not send me to baptize, but to preach the gospel, and not with the wisdom of human eloquence, so that the cross of Christ might not be emptied of its meaning. The message of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise, and the learning of the learned I will set aside. Where is the wise one? Where is the scribe? Where is the debater of this age? Has not God made the wisdom of the world foolish? For since in the wisdom of God, the world did not come to know God through wisdom, it was the will of God through the foolishness of the proclamation to save those who have faith. For Jews demand signs, and Greeks look for wisdom. But we proclaim Christ crucified, a stumbling block to Jews and foolishness to Gentiles. But to those who are called, Jews and Greeks alike, Christ the power of God and the wisdom of God. For the foolishness of God is wiser than human wisdom, and the weakness of God is stronger than human strength. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord.
The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord.
Exalt you just in the Lord. Praise from the upright is fitting. Give thanks to the Lord on the harp. With a 10-string lyre, chant his praises.
The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord.
For upright is the word of the Lord, and all his works are trustworthy. He loves justice and right. Of the kindness of the Lord, the earth is full.
The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord.
The Lord brings to naught the plans of nations. He foils the designs of peoples, but the plan of the Lord stands forever, the design of his heart through all generations.
The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. The foolish ones, when taking their lamps, brought no oil with them, but the wise brought flasks of oil with their lamps. Since the bridegroom was long delayed, they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, there was a cry, "Behold, the bridegroom, come out to meet him." Then all those virgins got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish ones said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are getting out." But the wise ones replied, "No, for there may not be enough for us and you. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves." While they went off to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went into the wedding feast with him. Then the door was locked. Afterwards, the other virgins came and said, "Lord, Lord, open the door for us." But he said in reply, "Amen, I say to you, I do not know you. Therefore, stay awake, for you know neither the day nor the hour." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Jesus ended our Gospel for today with a reminder and with a bang. Therefore, stay awake, for you know neither the day nor the hour. Sinabi niya po ang mga bagay na ito para habang tayo ay nakatayo at buhay ngayon, hindi tayo papatay-patay araw-araw. And as we have been saying, to live our lives to the fullest. But let me go back to the phrase, stay awake. Kinakailangan na kung nais nating mabuhay at kung alam natin na ang buhay na ito ay paghahanda o paglalakbay natin sa buhay natin sa itaas, kinakailangan nating maging gising. We need to stay awake. it could be possible that the five foolish virgins were not able to bring extra oil with them because by their very names, they were foolish. Ayaw mag-effort, ayaw magkaroon ng malay kung ano ang dapat dalin, ano ang dapat pang mga asikasuhin. And why did the five wise virgins were able to join the feast was because of that certain awareness. Gising sila kung ano ang dapat dalin. They were awake mind and heart to prepare what needs to be done and what needs to be brought. This call of our gospel is a daily challenge to all of us to stay awake. To stay awake not only to see blessings, but also to stay awake in order for us to see what we would need to improve, where we lack, where we are weak at. It pays to be awake whenever we lack the capacity to love, the capacity to understand, the capacity to forgive, the capacity to be present for others. But it pays as well to be awake that we know friends and others are blessing us. God has been caring for us. Life has been good to us. Dahil dito po nahulog yung limang dalaga. Dahil hindi sila mulat sa bagay na dapat nilang asikasuhin. Pero dito naman pinagpala ang limang mga babaeng ito. Dahil alam nila kung ano ang dapat gawin sa buhay na ito. Stay awake, my dear brothers and sisters, to see blessings and shortcomings. Kahit pagtingin kung anong kulang natin, kailangan nating magising. To see capacities and what needs to be done. Hindi lang para maging mulat sa biyaya, kundi sa mga pwede pang mabago sa atin. And by being awake, we know that the Lord, how the Lord will come and open the door for us to bless us, and He will come as well to shape us to be better and wise.
Please stand.
The gospel message reminds us to be wise and vigilant. As we wait for the coming of Jesus, let us pray for the world He has redeemed. For every petition, we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may read the signs of the times and constantly remind God's people of the eternal dimension of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That young people may remain hopeful and enthusiastic about life. May their idealism aid them in pursuing great things in life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those discouraged and wounded by life may not grow bitter, but draw fresh strength and hope from Christ, who promised us His presence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and the dying may look to Christ with hope and penitent trust. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may join the Lord in His kingdom forever. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray in silence for our own intentions as we lift up all the intentions offered in this Mass and our prayers for one another. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father of time and eternity, grant the petitions we have made as we wait for the coming of Christ, your gift of eternal wisdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, beloved brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O Lord, who gained for yourself a people by adoption through the one sacrifice offered once for all, bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your Church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Full of confidence, we call on God, our Father. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, that we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us, so that in all things we may please you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Maria, dinang